guess I'm going to walk. Oh, that milky white way. Oh, child, some of these days. Well, I'm going to walk that milky white way. Oh, some of these days. Well, 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 I'm going to walk up and take up my stand. Gonna join that Christian band. I'm going to walk, whoa, that milky white way. Oh, Lord, some of these days. I'm gonna tell my, oh, my mother.
And established it upon the floods. Who shall ascend unto the hill of the Lord? Or who shall stand in his holy presence? He that have clean hands and a pure heart, who have not lifted up his soul unto vanity, nor sworn deceitfully, he shall receive the blessing from the Lord and righteousness from the God of his salvation. This is the generation of them that seek him, that seek thy face, O Jacob. Lift up your heads, O ye gates, and be ye lift up, ye everlasting doors, and the King of glory shall come in. Who is this King of glory? The Lord, strong and mighty. The Lord, mighty in battle. Lift up your heads, O ye gates. Even lift them up, ye everlasting doors. And the King of glory shall come in. Who is this King of glory? The Lord of hosts. He is the King of glory. Amen. The psalmist reads, unto thee, O Lord, do I lift up my soul. O my God, I trust in thee. Let me not be ashamed. Let not my enemies triumph over me. Yea, let none that wait on thee be ashamed. Let them be ashamed which transgress without call. Show me thy way, O Lord, teach me thy path. Lead me in thy truth, and teach me, for thou art the God of my salvation. On thee do I wait all the day. Remember, O Lord, thy tender mercy and thy loving kindness, for they have been ever of old. Remember not the sins of my youth, nor my transgressions. According to thy mercy, remember thy name, for thy goodness' sake, O Lord. Good and upright is the Lord. Therefore, will he teach sinners in the way? The meek will he guide in judgment, and the meek will he teach his way. All the paths of the Lord are mercy and truth unto such as keep his covenant and his testimony. For thy name's sake, O Lord, pardon my iniquity, for it is great. What man is he that feareth the Lord? Him shall he teach in the way that he shall choose. His soul shall dwell at ease, and his seed shall inherit the earth. The secret of the Lord is with them that fear him, and he will show them his covenant. Mine eyes are ever toward the Lord, for he shall pluck my feet out of the net. Turn thee unto me, and have mercy upon me, for I am desperate and afflicted. The troubles of my heart are enlarged. O bring thou me out of my distress. Look upon my affliction and my pain, and forgive all my sins. Consider my enemies, for they are many, and they hate me with cruel hatred. Keep my soul and deliver me. Let me not be ashamed, for I put my trust in thee. Let integrity and uprightness preserve me, for I wait on thee. Redeem Israel, O God, out of all his trouble. Amen. Judge me, O Lord, for I have walked in mine iniquity. I have trusted also in the Lord. Therefore, I shall not slide. Examine me, O Lord, and prove me. Trust my reins and my heart. For thy loving kindness is before thine eyes, and I have walked in thy truth. I have not slept with vain persons, neither will I go in with dissemblers. I have hated the congregation of evildoers, and will not sit with the wicked. I will wash my hands in innocence, so will I compass thine altar, O Lord, that I may publish with the voice of thanksgiving and tell of all thy wondrous works. Lord, I have loved the habitation of thy house and the place where thine honor dwelleth. Gather not my soul with sinners, nor my life with bloody men, and whose hand is mischief, and thy right hand is full of bribes. But as for me, I will walk in my integrity. Redeem me, and be merciful unto me. My foot standing in an even place, in the congregation will I bless the Lord. says, the Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? The Lord is the strength of my life. Of whom shall I be afraid? When the wicked, even my enemies and my foes, came upon me to eat my flesh, they stumbled and fell. Though an host should encamp against me, my heart shall not fear. Though war shall rise against me, in this will I be confident. One thing have I desired of the Lord, that I will seek after, that I may dwell in the house of the Lord all the day of my life, to behold the beauty of the Lord and to inquire in his temple. For in the time of trouble, he shall hide me in his pavilion, in the secret of his tabernacle shall he hide me. He shall set me upon a rock. And now shall mine head be lifted up above mine enemies round about me. Therefore will I offer in his tabernacle sacrifices of joy. I will sing, yea, I will sing praises unto the Lord. Hear, O Lord, when I cry with my voice, have mercy also upon me, and answer me when thou sayest, seek ye my face. My heart saith unto thee, thy face, Lord, will I see. Hide not thy face far from me. Put not thy servant away in anger. Thou hast been my help. Leave me not, neither forsake me, O God of my salvation. When my father and my mother forsake me, then the Lord will take me up. Teach me thy way, O Lord, and lead me in a plain path because of mine enemies. Deliver me not over unto the will of mine enemy, a false witness, and risen up against me, and such as breathe out good. David said, I had fainted unless I had believed to see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. Wait on the Lord, be of good courage, and he shall strengthen thine heart. Wait, I say, on the Lord. Sons is Reeves, unto thee will I cry, O Lord, my rock. Be thou silent to me, lest if thou be silent to me, I become like them that go down into the pit. Hear the voice of my supplication. When I cry unto thee, when I lift up my hands toward thy holy earth, draw me not away with the wicked and with the workers of iniquity, which speak peace unto thy neighbors, but mischief in thy hearts. Give them according to thy deed and according to thy wisdom. Blessed be the Lord, because he hath heard the voice of my supplication. The Lord is my strength and my shield. My heart trusted in him, and I am helped, therefore, my heart greatly rejoices, and with my song will I praise him. The Lord is their strength, and he is the saving strength of his anointing. Save thy people and bless thine inheritance. Feed them also and lift them up forever. Amen. I give unto the Lord, O ye mighty, give unto the Lord glory and strength. Give unto the Lord the glory due unto his name. Worship the Lord in the beauty of holiness. The voice of the Lord is upon the voice. The glory is thunder. The Lord is upon the voice. The voice of the Lord is powerful. The voice of the Lord is full of majesty. The voice of the Lord breaks the seals. Again, the Lord breaks the seals of heaven. He makes them also still back again. The voice of the Lord divides the flames of fire. The voice of the Lord shaketh the wilderness. The Lord shaketh the wilderness of the nation. The voice of the Lord makes the hinds to pass and stops the forest. And in his temple, the very one speaks of his glory. The Lord sits upon the flood, yea, the Lord sits king forever. The Lord will give strength unto his people. The Lord will bless his people with peace.
afternoon. I'd like to thank you for allowing me to be here today. I'd also like to thank everyone who is in attendance today. As we look around the room, we see a lot of tears. Tears of sadness and tears of loss. But as Mary knows, and many of us know, on the other side of the veil, there's rejoicing that's taking place. Tears of happiness, tears of love, tears of uniting of loved ones. I remember, forgive me for saying I forgot to mention, my name's Dave Tucker. I'm the branch president of Americas of the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints. Ron actually served with us in our youth group. And I remember the camping trip that we went on. And I just remember the joy that he had serving with the youth and serving with those young men on that special camping trip. And of course, of the love that he had for his family, for Mary, for all of those who touched his life. He had a special heart about him. And there's no words that I can give today that will be able to replace him and the love that he has for you. But all I can do is say that the Lord loves him and to welcome him back into this fold at this time. And Mary, as we know, at some point, there are going to be tears on this side for when we leave this earth. But on the other side, when you're reunited with him, there's going to be tears of joy. Tears where we look to one another and we're not worried about the pain, we're not worried about the suffering, we're not worried about the loss. We're thinking about the reuniting, the love, and the gain of being together, the loved one. So please accept my heartfelt gratitude for allowing me to be part of this service. Truly and seriously, we would let the Savior take charge and to comfort those in need. And that's what you've done by being here today with this family. If you will, I'd like to tell a small story. And it talks about a loss or a funeral of a few months ago of a mother who had a rare, incurable disease that brought her pain and suffering in her 50s, and she died, leaving 14 brothers and sisters, 5 children, and 7 grandchildren. There were hundreds of family members in attendance. But things were different at this funeral. There wasn't any weeping or wailing, but there were very few tears. Everyone laughed and remembered how special he was and how she was and all the love was given. At the graveside service, we talked about how the son loved the mother, and again, it was noticed that nobody was miserable. They had all come from different parts of the country to attend the funeral, but they were there to be with one another. But they laughed, they remembered, and they caught up on each other's lives. What did they know that was different at this funeral? Why, in the face of such tragedy, they were so earnestly pleased at the family reunion that had spontaneously broken out at a funeral. They knew, of course, two things. First, they knew that death was only a temporary thing, that our spirits live on. They knew that Jesus had overcome death and allowed us to do that. If you will, in the scriptures reads that Mary stood without at the sepulcher, weeping, and as she wept, she stooped down and looked into the sepulcher and seeing 2 angels in white sitting, the one at the head and the other at the feet, where the body of Jesus had been laid. And they say unto her, Woman, why weepest thou? She saith unto them, Because they have taken away my Lord, and I know not where he is laid. And when she had said thus, she turned herself back and saw Jesus standing and knew not that it was Jesus. Jesus saith unto her, Woman, why weepest thou? Whom seekest thou? She, supposing him to be a gardener, saith unto her, Sir, if thou have borne him hence, tell me where thou hast laid him, and I will take him away. Jesus saith unto her, Mary. She turned herself and saith unto him, Rabboni, which is to say, Master. And of course, she finally recognized him as the resurrected Lord. I can say with certainty, as I said, that Mary, you will see Ronald again. Christ made that possible for all of us. He is reunited with loved ones now, and someday we'll see you all. Have faith, just like that family, that you will see him again. The family also knew the price that was paid for their beloved mother at that time. We all sin, we all fall short of God's glory, but Christ overcame that. In Luke we read, And he was withdrawn from them about a stone's cast, and kneeled down and prayed, saying, Father, if thou be willing, remove this cup from me. Nevertheless, not my will, but thine be done. And there appeared an angel unto him from heaven, strengthening him. And being in agony, he prayed more earnestly, and his sweat was there, with great drops of blood falling down to the ground. A dear price was paid for our salvation by someone who loves us all. He who sweat great drops of blood from every pore for the sins of the world, and he will be our judge. He who loves us enough to die for us, willing and quick to forgive and offer repentance and the fruits of salvation. I'm thankful for a Savior who loves us, and we owe him everything. It is because of that great atoning sacrifice, again, that I can promise you that Ron lives on and that you will see him again. I do pray that you will rejoice at this time, not again for your pain and your loss, but for his rebirth on that side of the veil. You are here, you will reminisce, you will love, you will hug. But remember, there are love and hugs that Ron would want to give you at this time. So as you embrace each other, cherish one another, cherish this time, but know, rest assured, that he is loved and that he has gone on and he has set the path for you. Scriptures go on. Now there stood by the cross of Jesus his mother. When Jesus therefore saw his mother and the disciple standing by whom he loved, he saith unto her, Mother, woman, behold thy son. Then saith he to the disciple, Behold thy mother. And from that hour that disciple took her unto his home. Just like the Savior's mother, you are going to carry Mary this day. Take care of her. Show her the love that she knows that you have for Ron, that you have for her. Your hearts will embrace her, will encircle her, and give her the strength to get through this. Or again, just like the Savior, we have to pass through this mortal coil to move on and then eventually return to our Heavenly Father. I know that God lives and He is my Redeemer, and He is the Redeemer for all of us. He paid the great sacrifice for our sins, and that we can return to Him. I say this in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen.
Thank you, Lord. The Lord initiated my life. I want to say, my uncle, the only place me as a father and a brother, a leader, a coach. I covered everything. He taught me how to treat a woman. I'm a man. I taught me how to be a child. He taught me how to be a seasoned life. Taught me how to be in church. And Uncle Joe, he taught me well. Taught me how to talk. And God, I said to me, we all love him. I think no one didn't meet him, but we love him. He was a soldier. I just want to say, thankfully having him in our life. I know he's been in all of us. Blessed be the name of the
I appreciate it. I love you. And couldn't ask for a better sister-in-law. So I say sister, you're always going to be in my life. But because like some of you, I got the opportunity to be with my brother for 62 years. And I know a lot of things about him. And one thing that I know that don't let that smile fool you. He wasn't the easiest person to live with. I think that's all of us, me, myself. But he was a good man. And he's probably the person that made me the man that I am today. Growing up, we fought. And we also made a pact that we wasn't going to fight anymore because I was going to hurt him or he was going to hurt me. So we made that pact. And Wednesday, I got the opportunity to say my last word to him. Just had a little brother time. And the only thing about it, he sat there and smiled at me, and he didn't talk back. And that was very unusual. But I came to the peace that my brother was basically looking at me, well, not looking at me, but smiling and saying that this is one journey that his little brother can't make with him. And I'm going to miss him. And I appreciate everything he has done for me. And I just say, he's always going to be with me because, you know, we talk 3-4 times a week at times. And we talk about everything. Is one of those guys that you would look at and say, okay, you can't make him mad, and he seems like him that way. But he always liked to have a good time. And I know that a lot of his nephews, nieces, friends, and stuff, they're going to miss him because he was just that good time person. So, I just want to say that y'all might have lost a good time, but you got the old boy and want to see it again.
Thank you. and just going to pray the same together. Because it may not be the time that you can't call on your family. Just remember to always call on him, and he's going to answer your prayer. So you look to the heads, you come to your head, and all your strength comes from the Lord. To the kids, the brothers, the sisters, the aunties, the brothers, the friends, I just want y'all to know, no matter where he gone, he lived a good life over here. Now he's with the Lord.
He wanted to let Miss Reed know, because Miss Reed was his second mom. Mr. Quiller Jr. is what I know him by. That's my cousin, third cousin. I didn't know that until today. I thought him and my mother was first cousin, which I still didn't know that until today. So Miss Reed, she would take my little boy home with her, and he would help her out around the house. Cousin Quiller Jr. one day seen that little boy when he came in from Pigs to Rochelle. He seen that little boy run out of my house. And he asked, he said, well, he said, I know that little boy. That little boy be at my house all the time. I said, Mr. Quiller Jr., that's my baby. He said, no, that's my baby. He said, me and my wife ain't got any, but that one there belong to me. That's why it's taking him, it's hurting him because of the fact that he found out it hurt him. And Miss Reed, that is his second mom. And whenever he comes into town, we live in Alabama, whenever he comes into town, Mama, I cannot go by Miss Reed. Can I go see Miss Reed? He wants Miss Reed to know that he loves you. He's going to be here with you throughout. Not just today, but he's going to continue to be here with you and for you. If you do not mind, continue to pray for him, and I will make certain that he continues to pray for you.
Is a spitting image of my dad, as y'all can see. When I looked at him, I just saw my dad, you know? And growing up, it's like I had two dads. They were like twins, night and day, like literally. I remember time when he was driving a big old 18-wheeler, I would see him just honking on, and I'd be like, ooh, I know who's coming. He would get out, he just smile, and he just lit up the room. And he was the only other man I let call me Snooks besides my dad. And he'd be like, Snooks, Snooks, Snooks. And I'd be like, Uncle, you can't call me that. He'd be like, yes, I can. But he just, every time we would go to Atlanta, we would stop by, pick him up, and we would sit there, we would talk sometimes. Next thing you know, he'd just be asleep. And I'd be like, go sleep so fast, like just talking. How you sleep? And I used to be like, Uncle Quill, why you keep snorking? I cannot say snore. I'm like, you snorking so loud. Why are you so loud? And now I see where my daddy get it from. It's loud. but he was the fun uncle. My dad was more the stern one, but he was the fun uncle. We had some good times, and them pies were magnificent. So I don't know who's gonna take over that, but some big shoes to fill. Them pies were, okay. But all in all, I'm sad because it's like when you walk in the reunion, you expect to see certain people, and it's like a void that kind of won't get filled. But I'm okay, and I hope everybody else is gonna be okay. Because now I think we all know that with everything that's going on, these moments, even though they're sad, we need to cherish them, because you'll be here today, you'll be gone tomorrow. So I want to say to my Auntie Mary Lou, Ron, and Dad, and family, I love y'all, and I'm here. If y'all want to call, text me, I'm here. And we're going to get through this. Uncle Quill want us to smile and not be sad and two-stepping the whole time, because you know he like to dance. So I'm going to miss him. But like I told I got you. I was telling my God.
Good afternoon. My name is Leon Troutman, and I'm the other side of the Reeves family, the Troutman and the Coles. We're the other side of this large family that we have. And I was actually Willie Jr., known him all my life. But, you know, we live directly behind him. So my dad, Logan Troutman, also been on the wheel. We were all right behind him. And we were a close-knit family, because I can even remember when LeVon and me used to go sneak boys, you know, in the back, you know, in the woods, because they know Uncle Quill was gonna kill them. And my sisters would say, hey, when they would sneak boys, they knew that my dad was gonna kill them. They knew anything about it. So they have a very close, we were a very close knit family. And Quilly Jr., as everybody said, he's always the individual who always had a smile on his face. Always interested in having fun. And if I had to say anything, if he had to say anything today, he would have a big sign over this cast that says, I am not here. He is with the Lord. He would say, I am not here. What you see is a body that has been replaced with a new body. And ask me how I know if I had the opportunity to go to the other side. I know what it's like. You do get a new body. So, let's rejoice that we know that he knew the Lord Jesus and he's saved. And let's rejoice that we get the opportunity to see him again. Thank you.
Friends, at this time, we would have a solo by Brother Chris Taylor. Let's loosen up in here. Let's give God a hand clap of praise in here. Y'all loosen up. We know it's a funeral, but it's a homegoing celebration. On my way home. On my way home. Y'all, yeah, put your hand
on my way home.
On my way home. Sometimes, on my way home. mistreated sometimes. Oh, how many of y'all get mistreated sometimes? I've been mistreated sometimes.
Oh, my way.
Oh, I get mistreated sometimes. I want to fix the Jesus. Come on, y'all. I want to fix me, Jesus. I want to fix me, Jesus. Y'all don't hear me. I want to fix my heart. I want to fix my heart. I want to fix my mind. I want to do it for me right now. 'Cause I know you're able. Anybody need fixing? Anybody need fixing? Somebody need fixing? If you need fixing, every now and then, I'll get down on your knees. I'll tell them fix me, Jesus. I want you to go by the hospital. Somebody needs you. Somebody laying there. A racking with pain. Hey! One touch from you, Lord, I'll make it all right. Can I get a witness? Can I get a witness? Can I get a witness? On my way home.
On my way home.
On my way home, yeah. On my way home,
on my way home.
Come on, Lord, please, Lord, like you said you would. Yeah, yeah, yeah,
oh yeah.
What a friend we have in Jesus, all our sins and griefs to bear. What a privilege it is to carry everything to God in prayer. Oh, what peace we often forfeit. Oh, what needless pains we bear. All because we do not carry everything to God in prayer. The family of the late United States Army veteran, Mr. Ronald Quill Reeves, is most appreciative for all the many kind and loving expressions of sympathy shown to them during this time of sorrow. They ask for your continued prayers in the days ahead. May each of you continue in the blessings of the Lord Jesus Christ. Flowers have been sent in loving memory of Mr. Reeves. May the Almighty provide peace and comfort for you and your family through this great loss, especially your mom, from Brother Ed. In loving memory of Mr. Ronald Reeves, our thoughts and prayers are with you, David and Morris. In loving memory of Mr. Ronald Reeves, heaven has added an angel. May his memory be forever in our hearts and prayers. We love you, Unc. Rest in peace. With deepest sympathy, nephew Gabe and niece Tara Torres. With deepest sympathy, your neighbors, Marcus and Donna Jenkins. With deepest sympathy, the Wilcox County High School, class of 1974. With deepest sympathy, the staff of Wilcox Head Start and Lydia Owens and Miss Norma Emery. It is with deepest sympathy, the Pine City Baptist Church family, Reverend Ernest Weaver, Pastor, Rochelle, Georgia. With deepest sympathy to the family of Quill Reeves, Quatana, Johnson, and family. With all our prayers and deepest sympathy to the family from Inez Davis, Dee Dee Jones, Darren Thrower, and Diane Thrower. In loving memory of Dr. Napoleon Williams, Deacon Arthur L. Parker, CEO and President of the J.W. Williams Funeral Home and staff, we present this family African American heirloom Bible in hope that it serves as a source of added comfort and peace in the days to come. For scripture tells us that weeping may endure for a night, but joy cometh in the morning. The J.W. Williams Funeral Home presents to this family a pictorial tribute of your loved one's life. It is our hope that you will forever remember the many cherished memories you've shared together. Finally, the J.W. Williams Funeral Home presents this family with a memorial blanket. It is our prayer that you wrap yourself in the love and warmth that this blanket holds. It is our prayer that you are blessed now and always.
For as much as it has pleased the Almighty God in his own wise providence to take out of the world the soul of our deceased brother, we therefore commit his body unto the ground, earth to earth, ashes to ashes, and dust to dust, looking for the general resurrection and the last day, the coming of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, in whom second cometh in his own glory and majesty to judge the world, the earth, and the sea shall give up their dead, and the corruptible bodies of those that sleepeth in them shall be changed, and made like it unto his own glorious body, whereby according to the mighty works he is able to subdue all things unto himself. I heard a voice from heaven saying, write, henceforth blessed are the dead, they that die in the Lord, that they rest from their labor, and their work do follow them. Let us pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed would be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us of our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, and deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever. Now may the once crucified, dead, buried, risen, and ascended Savior, go with this his people, both now and forevermore. And we all say, amen.